use the block or use cushion or booster, anything that allow your hips to be higher than your knees. Move side to side until you feel your sit bone resting on the mat, on the cushion, on the block. Relax the shoulders back and down. Inhale and exhale. Inhale to your nose and exhale. Sigh out to your mouth. Let go all the tension down to the earth. Inhale. Exhale. So while you keep your eyes closed, softly and gently, keep one hand close to your baby. Keep the other hand close to your heart, front of your chest. Feel your belly, feel your chest. Rest toward your palms while you're inhaling. Feel your chest drop back, the belly drop back when you're exhaling. Every inhaling, visualize you're taking in of oxygen to nourish each and every part in your body. And every exhaling, you let go all the negative energy that no longer serving you. Allow each breath to become longer and deeper. Allow each breath to transfer more positive energy to your body, to your legs, to your arms. And let go the negative energy through your out-breath. For the next 5 deep breaths, when we exhale, we're gonna make the Om sound. Allow the vibration to travel to each and every part in your body, to each and every muscle cells, all the way to your baby. Let your baby, let your body receive the positive energy from the word Om while you exhale. So remember, our breathing is different. If your Om is shorter or longer than me, it's absolutely okay. Go with your own pace, all right? So inhale. Another 2 rounds. Yeah. So still keep your eyes closed. So use the chance to connect between your heart and your baby heart. Tell your baby how much you love your baby and how you prepare your body physically, mentally, emotionally during this pregnancy, that one day you meet your baby and have her within your arms close to your heart, and how you want your baby girl to help you during this pregnancy to make it smooth, beautiful, all the way until the day that you give birth to her. Tell her that you work as a team. Tell her that she is enough. She is strong. She is powerful. Because you're taking care of her. You're taking care of yourself. You're taking care of your body. And for you too, my mother, tell yourself, I am strong. I am powerful. I am healthy. And I am enough. I prepare myself each and every day that I can't wait to see my baby girl all the way until I give birth to her and have her within my arm. I can't wait to initiate the breastfeed, to nourish her from my blood, from my milk, the love that I share to her. And now, bring your awareness to your own breathing. And slowly open your eyes. Alright, so from here, let's do some the normal stretch that we always do. Inhale, bring your arms up. Sweep your arms up, look up to the ceiling, and keep your left hand out, right hand up. Try to lengthen your spine here and give me a big circle on your right shoulder. One. Two. Yes. And three. And now reverse the circle. Feel the gentle stretch at the right side of your body. One more round here. Inhale and exhale. And now we switch. So keep your left hand up, right hand down. Lengthen your spine. And now give me a big circle on the left shoulder. And now reverse the circle. Very good. One more round here. Inhale and exhale. And from the side bending, gonna be the easy opening twist. Keep your left hand back. Keep the right hand to the front. Lengthen your spine and look over your left shoulder. Inhale, bring your arms up. Sweep your arm up towards ceiling and exhale. Right hand to the back, left hand to the front. Lengthen your spine and look over your right shoulder. And continue, do like this for the next four deep breaths. Inhale. Exhale. So whenever you exhale, let go the tension physically and mentally that no longer serving you. Two more deep breaths. Then back to the center. Now hold the elbows over the head. Slowly from here, I want you to lengthen your spine. Feel every breath, you're sitting taller and taller. Create the space between each and every spinal bone, each and every vertebra. Inhale and exhale like someone pulling your body up towards the sky. 3, 2, 1, more deep breath. Inhale. And now exhale. Give me a mini circle here. Feel the stretch at your lower back, at the side of your body, at the front of your body. And now reverse. One more deep breath here. Inhale. And exhale. So relax the shoulder back and down. All right. And now from here, we're going to sit in hero pose. So you may use the booster. All right. Sit with the booster between your legs. I'm going to show you from the other side. All right. Your knees going to be open. Your toes going to be close to each other. So it's going to be knees open and toes toward each other. And slowly from here, do it slowly, do it gently. Mainly, I want you to feel the stretch at the front of your ankle joint all the way to the front of your shin bone. Hands behind. You're going to lift the right knee up and gently lift your left knee up. So up enough that you feel the stretch at the front of your ankle joint. 10. 9, 8, 7, yes, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and slowly from here, my love, you're gonna lift your both knees up. Use maybe 10 to 15% of your effort, all right? Option one, your hand is there, or option two, woo! Keep your hands on the knee. This option gonna be a little challenge, but why not? We love challenging. Inhale to your nose, sigh out, to the mouth. One more deep breath. Inhale. And slowly from here, relax. So now you're going to tuck the toes. Keep each and every toe touch the floor. Either you sit on the block or you sit on your own buttock. Okay, however, here I want you to feel that each and every toe touch the floor. Inhale to your nose, exhale, let go your entire body weight down to your toes. Inhale. One more deep breath. And and slowly from here, direct to the all four. Shoulders above your hands and your hips above your knees. Lift the toes up and circle your toes up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Reverse. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good job. Then from here, keep your left leg straight. Lift your body up and keep your right arm straight to the front, left leg straight to the back. Lengthen your spine and engage your deep core muscles. Stay here for 3 deep breaths. And now keep your right hand down. Just have a look, bend at your left knee and kick your left foot up towards ceiling. 10, 9, 8, very good. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Same leg, I want you to open the left groin area. Keep open the hip as wide as your body allow you to do so. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And now you may have a look. You're gonna keep your left leg straight up. Point the left toe away. You're gonna lift your left arm up. Try to lift the left leg up as high as your body allows to. Lengthen your spine. Lift the left leg up higher and higher. 3, whoa, 2, and 1. Slowly from here, back to where we start. Left knee back. This time, right leg straight back. Right leg up. Lift your body up tall and keep your left arm straight forward. Stay here for 3 deep breaths. And now, relax. Keep the left hand down. Now bend at your right leg, right? And kick your right leg up. Yes. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then open the hip, circle the right groin area. 3, 4, 5, yes, 6, 7, 8, 9. And now turn to me. Lift your right leg as high as you can. Lift your right arm as high as your body allow you to do so. Stay for 3, 2, and 1. Then slowly from here, back to the center. Now you might have a look once again. Keep your knees open and you keep your toes together. Extend your arm forward and keep your palms down. Inhale, you're gonna lean forward. Now have a look again. Your knee is gonna be open like this. And you keep your toes together, okay? So knees open, toes together. Extend your arms forward. And remember, forward enough that your palms, your knees, your toe stay at the same spot. Because when you inhale, you're gonna lean forward without your hip touching to the floor, right? Lengthen your spine, open your chest, shoulders away from the ears. So this is inhale. The challenge part here when you exhale, do your best not moving your palms, your knees, and your toes. Sit back to where we start. Cool. We're gonna do this for the next 5 deep breath. Inhale. You push forward, you should feel at your inner thigh, not really at the back. Yeah, so you should feel that you push your hip to the front and lengthen your spine. It's mainly gonna be you stretch your inner thigh, and when you sit back, yes, this time you should feel the relief at your lower back. So inhale, push your hip forward, lengthen your spine, open your chest, and exhale, sit back. So this time with the modified child pose, you should feel a lot of relief at your lower back. 2 more deep breaths. And slowly back to all 4. Nod your head side to side to feel the gentle stretch at the opposite side of your neck. Half circle from right to the left, and half circle from left to the right. And do as much as your body allow you to do so. Okay, from here, keep your palms firmly down to the floor, tuck the toes. Exhale, lift your buttock up high, direct to downward facing dog. And because of your nausea, make sure that you need to do even gentler and slower. Walk tip of your toes to the front of the mat. Keep your knees soft and slowly relax the elbows on the knees. Look straight for the halfway lift. Inhale, raise your arms up tall. So sweep your arm up towards ceiling and exhale, relax your hands at the front of your chest. Now, either you keep your eyes closed or you open your eyes, either way, feel you shift the weight to the toes, to the heels. You shift the weight equally to your right foot, to your left foot. And bring your awareness back to the center of your body. Each and every breath, lengthen your spine up tall. One hand slowly closer to your baby, the other hand closer to your heart. Inhale all the way down to the womb, to your baby. Exhale, gently draw the navel towards spine. So for the next 5 deep breaths, we're gonna say the word ah together for 5 rounds. Actually, I should not say the word together because our breathing is different. Say the word when you exhale for 5 breaths as long as you can. Slowly from here, bring your arms up, inhale, and slowly exhale. Keep your knees softly, hinge your hip to the back wall, and now keep your palms down. Extend your right leg back as far as you can. Rest your right leg, your right knee, your right ankle joint. And slowly, you're gonna turn the left toe to the left side. So slowly from here, before you start, I want you just pushing the left knee away with your left hand, right? And gently look back. Stay for 3, 2, 1, then back to the center. And before you start, if you have any doubt, you might just have a look first. You're gonna circle your hip. So observe my left foot. So when you circle it out, you're gonna open the left foot just slightly. Yes. Feel the gentle stretch at your left inner thigh. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Slowly from here, step your left back and gently step your right foot forward. Right foot outside the right hand, yeah? Let go the weight of your left leg, left knee, left toe. Turn the right toe to the right side and pushing the right knee away with your right hand and slowly look over your right shoulder. 3, 2, and 1. And gently here, have a look again. You're gonna circle the right knee out. Observe my right foot. When you open the right hip, you open the right foot as well. Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Then step your right leg back. So back to the center here. So if you have any doubt, just let me know. Yeah, step your right foot forward. Extend your right leg back. Left knee be aligned with your left ankle joint. Slowly from here, you're leaning forward. Inhale and exhale. So inhale, you're leaning forward. and exhale. I think I remember you have any tension, any sensitivity below the knee. So remember, allow yourself to go beyond your comfort zone, get something to support below your back knee. All right, let's start again. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Have a look. Left foot forward. It should be right hand forward. Okay, keep your left hand relaxed on your left knee. You're gonna bend your right knee up and down. 5, 4, 3, 2, and hold on. If possible, draw your left hand back and hold your right toes. Lengthen your spine. Good. Now I'm gonna count to 5, hey? Do your best to keep your right foot closer and closer to your buttock. 5, 4, and make sure never hold your breath. 3, do as much as your body allow you to do so, hey my love. And release slowly. So what I see is, I can see you love to push yourself. That's good. However, just push enough that your body allow you to do so. When we do the yoga, when we do the workout, you just feel like me. You don't need to look like me because our bodies is different. Yeah, that's number one. Number two, whenever you hold this one, like, oh, awesome, it's really hurt, I'm gonna stop it and let it go immediately. That is how people got the injury. So make sure that, oh, dang, it's really painful. Yeah, but I'm gonna slowly out of the pose. So in this way, not only you bring awareness to yourself, but also reduce the injury, because remember, once we do the online session together, I'm not there with you to correct your position. You have to just bring even the double awareness to your position. And also, my dear, because stop yoga for 10 days is also like a big difference. The flexibility is also reduced as well. Also, the timing that we do is also different. So listen to your body. All right. Now, step your right foot forward and relax the left knee. Keep your cushion support below the left knee. Yeah. So from here, inhale, bring your arms up. Exhale, circle your shoulders. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, more deep breath here. Inhale and exhale, right foot forward, left hand forward. And now gently bend at your left knee up and down slowly. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. From here, you can stay where you are, or you try to hold the left toe with your right hand. Just stay like that. No problem at all. Or you're gonna try to keep the left foot close your body. If it's so much, just let go slightly. It doesn't need to make it perfect. I just want you to feel a deeper stretch at the front of your left leg. Make sure never hold your breath. One more deep breath here, inhale, and gently let go the left toe, and slowly step your right knee back. And now keep your knees apart, keep your toes together, and make a fist at your both hands, and raise your forehead on the fist. Raise your forearms on the floor and let go your entire body weight down to the ground. Shoulders away from the ears. Inhale slowly and exhale slowly. Let go the tension physically and mentally that no longer serving you, your body, and your baby, down towards the ground. And slowly come up. So this time we're gonna use ball, but before we start, let's sip some water and pick up your ball. Whap. Ta-da. Okay. Yep. So, sit comfortable on the ball. Sway your body side to side. Yes. Inhale and exhale slow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And circle the hip. So we're gonna start from clockwise or go to any direction that you feel comfortable. And slowly from here, reverse, reverse. Good, good. And now I'm gonna show you from the other direction. So you're gonna give me the pelvic rock. Inhale, exhale. So push the hip forward. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. So check, yeah. Do our best to keep the knees bent 90 degrees and keep the feet flat to the floor. Do our best to lengthen the spine so you don't lean back or you don't leaning forward. Okay. Feel your sit bone touching to the ball. Before you start, you might have a look first. I'm going to show you from another direction as well. So, this is the way that we're going to sit, right? So keep your left hand by the side. Lengthen your spine. Right arm up and slowly side bend to the left. And slowly circle the right shoulder. 3. Two and reverse. 3. Two one and gently back to the center. And now keep your right hand out. Lengthen your spine and bring your right arm up, side bending to the right side. And give me a big circle on your left shoulder. And now reverse, reverse. One more deep breath. Inhale and exhale. Then slowly from here, bring your arms up. You're gonna twist to the right side. Keep your right hand behind the hip. Left hand on your right knee. So lengthen your spine first. And slowly look over your right shoulder. 3, 2, 1. Inhale, gently draw your arms up back to the center and now twist to the left. Left hand behind the hip, right hand, yes, on the left knee. Lengthen the spine and look over the left shoulder. One more deep breath. Inhale and exhale back to the center and slowly from here standing up. All right, then next workout. Keep the ball against the wall and keep the ball support your lower back from the tailbone, the sit bone, all the way to your lower back. So it should be somewhere lower than your middle back. Yep, all right. Then from there, keep your feet. We're gonna do it 30 times, all right? So the first, keep your feet wider than your hip width apart, okay? Inhale, you might step your foot slightly forward and you give me the squat. So when you do the squat, make sure you still see the toes. So because I didn't see your toes, I just want to make sure that when you do, it's more like when you do the squatting, right? The knee not go forward, let the knee go to the back. Knee still behind the toes, yes. So 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now from here, keep your feet open wider. Sumo squat. Turn the toes out. So this time when you go down, knees and toe go to the same direction. Good, good. Just before you start, how you feel about your back? It's okay, yeah? All right. So 10 times. Let's go. So make sure you might have to step your feet forward more. Keep your feet a little bit further away from the wall. All right? Weight to the heels. When you lift your body up, push your body up from your both heels. Okay. Up. Exhale. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Almost there. Nine. And 10. Now just shake your leg because it's not enough yet. So let me challenge you just a little bit. Keep the ball a little bit lower than your middle back. Alright? Keep your feet wider than your hip width apart. Think about a sumo squat. Knee and toe go to the same direction. Now you're gonna go down enough that your whole back is being supported at the ball behind you. Feel that you're working at your inner thigh. Weight to the heels and give me a pulsing small move. Pressing from the heels. 10, 9, 8, 7, almost there, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. So from here, let's modify the triangle pose. Because you already have the ball, support especially at your lower back. So pressing your bum towards the ball, yeah? Left toe turn to the left side, right toe slightly turn to the left. Arms up. Inhale here and exhale. Now try to pressing your butt towards to the ball. Open the chest and lengthen your spine. So you feel like you try to lean back, but back enough that you press the ball towards the wall. And awesome love circle. Inhale and exhale. Circle the right shoulder here. And reverse, my love. 3, 2, and 1. Look down first and slowly bring your body up. Now, adjust the ball again if necessary. The ball support mainly at your bum, at your buttock, at your lower back. Left toe slightly turn to the right side. Right toe completely turn to the right side. Inhale and exhale. Now what I want, lean back and pressing your buttock towards the ball, yeah? Lengthen your spine here and give me a big circle on the left shoulder. Do it slowly and reverse. Three, two, last one, my love. And now look down to the floor and bring your body back up to the center. Still have two more workout here with the ball. So now keep the ball up over the head. Yep. I can't believe it's, yeah, that the ball is like almost out from the screen. So I'm gonna show you from this side. You're gonna keep your legs open as wide as you can. I keep it open like maybe 2 steps apart. 1, 2. Then from here, I'm gonna do the deep squat and tap the ball down to the floor. And up, exhale. So from here, it's gonna be inhale and up. Exhale. Oh yeah. Nine. So hinge your hip to the back. Yeah. 8 7 6 almost there, halfway. 4 3 2 one more time and one. Woohoo! Still not done yet. So now sip the water first. You have last two workout with the ball. With a C again. Cool, almost there. So from here, you're gonna kneeling. When you kneel, tuck the toes. You need the wall now, yes. Alright. So with the kneel position here, is also the side bending as well. Tuck the toes, keep the ball on the left side, lift the right hand up, and slowly from here, you're gonna try to extend the ball as far as you can to the left. And keep your right hand up. And slowly from here, you switch, turn, right arm straight, left arm over the head. Inhale and exhale. Four. Three. Two. One. And you know what? Last exercise. Keep the ball really close to your hip. Because when you lean forward, I just see that there is no space between side of your body and the ball. And keep your right leg straight. Slowly from here, right hand support the head. Lift the right leg up and tap down slowly. 10. Yes, you can just hug the ball. 9 8 7 6 5 4 3 2 Challenge yourself. Right leg, right hand. Open your chest, look up. 3 2 1 And slowly from here, my love. The other side. Yay, almost there. So keep the ball really close to your hip first. Then you lean, alright? Why that's so? Sometimes people just lean immediately and you see that is the space, yeah? So do your best to leave no space here. Left hand support the head. And now you kick your right, sorry, the left leg up. One, landing softly. Two. Three, four, five, six, almost there, 7 8 9 and hold on, right, oh sorry, left leg, left hand. 5 4 3 2 and 1 And now from here, we are done. So keep your knees apart, keep your toes together. You can rest your body, keep your forearm on the ball, rest your forehead on your forearm. Inhale slowly, exhale. Remind yourself of the primal sound. When you exhaling, let go the tension, the negative energy down towards our Mother Earth. And use this chance to connect with your baby once again. Just visualize, imagine that your baby also rest like you are resting. Imagine that your baby relaxed. Her legs, her arms. And visualize every time you inhale, your oxygen, your positive energy travel all the way down to the womb, to the baby, like electricity that create the light, and this light allow the womb to be bright and shine. Allow each and every muscles, each and every cells of your baby to become bright and shine. As electricity, this positive energy travel to each and every part. And now not only your babies and your womb, but also now your belly become bright and shine. Your body become bright and shine as the energy penetrate to each and every part of your back. Your arms become bright and shine as you can feel the heat, feel the warmth. Your neck, your face, your head. And now you can imagine this light, bright and shy penetrate to your legs, to your knees, to your calf, to your feet, to your toes. So imagine that your body is bright enough that lighten your room, lighten this room. The light is warm enough that you share to me, that you share the love, the positive energy to people surrounding you. And now imagine this bright light shining, slowly travel all the way back to the center of your body, like a small crystal ball. And travel up towards to your third eye. Allow you to use your instinct. Allow you to activate the mother intuition. So you can feel how your baby feels. So you can share the feeling to your baby. So you can feel the positive energy to your baby. And slowly from here, my dear, keep your eyes open. And we are done.